All right, folks, we're here for another adventure, another overnighter. We're on the top of the Hatchie tonight. Me and Mr. Farr.
Water's a little colder.
It's a little colder.
A
little colder than the Gulf. We're going to go hit some springs. Going to maybe catch some catfish or something. Tyler's got some funky catfish bait we're going to try out.
Yeah,
and plenty of groceries. You bring Tyler with you, he's going to buy the whole Piggly Wiggly.
Well, and we just passed the lifeboat from the movie Captain Phillips right back there. So.
We'll just show y'all that to y'all on the way out. No telling what we're going to get into. Lost my darn hat. I didn't think this little 30 could do that. Learned how to drive, don't I? Nice catch.
First catch of
the day. Hey, at least we caught something.
Can't eat that one, bud.
We may not catch any fish, but we'll catch
we'll
a darn
that sucker up
cast iron. Yeah. Woo! Woo! That's too cold. Alright, let's try this again. Thank you, sir.
Supposedly. It'd be straight ahead on the right.
Alright.
Yeah, the water changes a little bit. Only it's clear.
Last time I was caught here in a thunderstorm and I got right up by them cypress trees over there. But the closer you get to the blue hole, you know, the less muddied up it'll be by the river.
Yeah. I love these old cypress trees.
Yes, sir. Water's a little high, but we're still cruising back here to the spring. The water's definitely clearing up.
God dang, that's clear in hell.
Yeah, it is.
I can see the bottom back there. Look at that.
Yeah, man.
Look at that size of that joker.
That's a white Amur. That's like a grass carp.
A white Amur?
Yeah.
I thought you just made that up.
All right,
oh,
now.
Oh, man. Yep. Look at this stuff. Are you kidding me?
All right, so this is kind of one of the little bowls. This is one of the spots I thought
we could
camp. I don't know if you want to camp here or not.
Oh, my God. Where's my boat fishing rig?
This is the spot, man. Hey, yes, sir. It's good enough for you.
Hell yeah, I love it.
Now, the other spring's just right there. Water's just pumping up out of the bottom.
Here we are, me and Tripper, in this spring. I'm going to tell you, I've never heard of it.
That cold, is it? It was 49 last night, so the water's pretty chilly. I don't know.
I wish I hadn't manscaped yet, so I had a little more fur on me.
We're here at spring. Tyler's acting a trooper.
I already did the trip dip. I could shave a diamond right now, I'll tell you that.
I'm sure I ain't even in the water. But all right, let's go. Thank you for reminding me, Tyler. Trip dip!
Oh, grist, baby.
Probably 30 foot deep. Look over here where you stand up, put them off. When you go beyond the spring and it clears up. I'm telling you, you're gonna, it's a game changer. Get that off, got a little, let me get the ring. It's not that cold. I mean, yeah. It's chilly.
Well, once you get in,
yeah.
We ain't going over, you're gonna get hypothermic.
Not in 20 minutes. That's cool.
That's real cool. I wanna come out here in the summer. I really think it feels nice.
Oh, it does in the summer, man. Yeah.
I feel my water bottle up here.
Uh-huh.
I feel my water bottle.
Yeah. It feels good now.
Yeah.
I'm good with it.
All right, now we're headed back up in the creek, back to another spring, the one I caught the folks fornicating at. Maybe we'll get to see it this time.
It'll probably be a little chilly this time.
Probably a little chilly for them now. Water's pretty high. Hopefully we can get back up in there, because this boat's a little bigger than the Ginu. And the Ginu struggled. Yeah, we're struggling trying to find a spot to camp. There's a lot of swamp and hard to get up in the trees.
There's one runway out, that's one. Oh, I almost dropped my camera.
You've been swimming for it. All right, okay, hold on. I need to put it right here. This might have been the left.
Him. All right, so we're trying to find this spring. Everything looks different. Yeah, look, see the ropes on the limbs.
The ropes?
It's gotta be it. Hey, look straight ahead.
We see it. There's a boil right there.
Right there.
All this crap looks the same. Like the water just goes off into the trees, and you can't tell anything.
Yeah, you can tell.
Yep.
There's a little more backwoods.
This is the redneck spring.
This is the redneck spring. Whoopie spring. What we'll call it.
What's the temperature here?
Feels about the same.
Feels warmer to me.
Yeah, it ain't that cold.
I think this one warm bad. Morning bath service.
I don't think so. Far spa. Yeah. We think we spotted a spot to camp. Just a little bit further back. Up amongst the trees, so. No. Heck no. Yeah, if something goes down, we're in the middle of nowhere. Yeah, it's tough to get this boat back up in here, but it's worth it. Yeah, that one's just it's not pumping very hard.
Not as much as it
is. No.
You got that limb coming up. Alright, where are we going to cut up in there at? It was right to the left of that big tree, wasn't it? What if I cut left right there? Yep. Beautiful. Right there by that hog's eye.
Got the water in here.
I know it, man. All right, this will be our camp for the night.
Man, hog camp.
Hog camp.
We had a roof. The sow house.
It was hard to find dry lands. Whenever we spotted it pretty close that we could get to, we're going to call it home. Let's get far, get all this produce off here.
Chum the hogs in.
I'm still shivering from the spring.
Damn, they been all over me.
All right, we're getting some firewood together. Tyler's getting the fire going. We got some boudin and red hots, and I can't remember what else.
Oh, half the pig and wiggly.
Half the pig. We got some ranch style beans, you know, all kind of good stuff to cook tonight. It's gonna be fancy. Chef Boyardee over here.
Fire going.
Smoked tuna dip, boudin, chicken hearts, turkey, red hots. Some souse. We've got it all. Here we got American cheese. Where's the loaf of bread?
Oh, it's up there somewhere.
Do we have it?
Yeah, oh yeah. I got a little tree frog on my bread.
Loaf of bread and some Doritos. Give Tyler some Tito's and Doritos, he's good to go. Hot Tossie's on the fire. Tyler bought us a cast iron skillet.
Chef Boyardee.
We'll see how far his Chef Boyardee skills go.
They go a long way, man.
You did find the honey hole.
They give me a little street cred. A little bit of, just a touch of peanut oil to season the pan.
Oh, yeah. Zubo's Cajun style boudin.
Yeah.
The good news is. What's the good news?
No sand.
No sand.
No sand. Right there, son. That, you don't like that, your wood's wet. Oh, come on.
Now we got it.
Ooh. It's gonna be hot quickly. I don't know what I'm gonna grab the cast iron skillet with. I'll have to get some mud on our hands.
Chef Boyardee? Chef Boyardee.
Under his eye.
Smoking it with the gunpowder.
That's right. Turn me on to something, man.
Hey, that's good stuff, man. Want to stop up by the Piggly Wiggly and get some of that to take to Tennessee.
Yeah, I'd have bought stock in the Piggly Wiggly because I'd have pretty much savaged that joke. We only have a plastic fork. Or...
Yeah, we got these tongs.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's right. Come
on. What's that?
Smoke in the eyes. A little smoky. Oh, yeah. Oh, that jug is hot.
Ain't good for that first. Oh, Lord.
Your Alabama bubbler. We are cooking it.
That's a little too hot,
okay,
I'm afraid.
Yeah, we are.
He's scorched right there.
Western sizzling.
Or Pittsburgh style.
Put them away now.
I'm going to get the old black. Yeah, that'll work. Thank you, sir.
Forgot the mustard and mayo, but
at least we got.
Come on, man. One more step. Come on.
Get in the hog hole.
The hog's been rooting right here. They got little landmines everywhere.
God damn.
Like we're enamored with all these booby traps.
They're pretty good, though.
Yeah, they work. Man, you should have taken one more step, man. A step and a leap, and you would have been rich.
Well, I'm going to go home looking like I got back from Vietnam.
All scratched up. All right, so we got a little special family recipe bait Tyler's going to whip together. What do we got going here?
We got chicken hearts. We're going to throw them in there. Might need a lot of them.
In our Walmart bag with a hole in it? Hopefully not.
Yeah, probably. Put a little bit of red Kool-Aid in there. That's what we do it in Tennessee. So, pay close attention. It's very precise.
Sure.
Well, this is a knockoff brand, Flavor Aid.
Uh-oh. The Bobo stuff work? If you were a catfish, you'd bite it.
Yeah. What we do here? Put it all on them chicken hearts.
Whatever you say, man.
Then, a little twisty.
Good to go.
Don't put that in my goddamn boat.
No, you don't want that in the boat.
No, let's put it in one of them tins.
No, why you want the boat?
Because that crap's leaking everywhere.
Think it's going to stain your boat.
Yeah, man, it might stain the boat.
Yeah, probably will. I wasn't going to put it in your boat.
I know you weren't.
That'd be a bad idea. That'd be a bad friend move. I'm telling you.
All right. I hope so, because if not, there's pork brains and coming down the pipe. If we don't catch no fish, we got to eat some pork brain.
I'm turning the fear factor here. Fear factor will far.
Far factor.
Yeah, the far factor.
Hey.
Porting out? Yeah, Lorilla.
That works. Come on, man. Get some boudin.
No, I'm filming. Those things look too weird for me to eat.
Oh, that's the way I like it, man.
I used to have a donkey.
Yeah?
Is it like when you're like in a Catholic church and they go, do this in remembrance of me.
Yeah.
It'd be like my old donkey. Like, here's the bill. Yeah. Them red hots, though, now, too. Those are pretty righteous. Thanks to old Lou Ann's peanut oil. Got my canned goods. I think we're going to make a venture out to the mainland. Well, not the mainland. We're going out to the river. I'm trying to catch some fish. I've done talk tripping to it.
It's a bad idea. We're going to go with it.
All I have are bad ideas. I promise you. I promise you.
But bad ideas turned into good adventures.
But hey, this is a great camping spot. I've yet to put up my hammock, which I probably should do right now before it gets dark. So, peace out.
This is going to be rough. If somebody finds this camera, give the money to our wives.
Yeah.
Yeah, they are pretty good. All right, so we're about to head out on the boat. Farrah had an idea. Let's go out here at night amongst this swamp that we're not familiar with.
Great idea.
Let's try to go fishing. So,
right on, yeah.
Always an adventure. Here we go.
Do a trip dip right now?
Negative. Ain't no trip dip happening tonight. Unless it's accidental. I hope it ain't.
Go for a minute. Yeah. We're trying over here. Like, which way do I go right now? I got this GPS.
You're good. Yeah, that's going to blind.
Left. We're going left, I think.
Yeah, this is
going
to blind us. Hey, y'all hold on.
Don't.
I think we're going left.
I got four of them if I do. tell them what happened.
Man, we about lost it, man. I don't know. We hit a tree, then hit the throttle, hit reverse, hit forward. I about fell over. Far was grabbing trees, trying to keep us from wrecking. This is going to be something.
It's an expedition, man.
It's a bad idea. A bad idea turned into a good time.
Bad news is I don't have any good ideas. They're all bad. But But at least the red hawks are good.
I'm ready for them ranch beans.
Yeah. There's the bait. We got it marinating. I have no clue where we're at.
This GPS says I can see our path. So.
Can you?
Yeah. We're about to take a right somewhere.
They're about to take a right somewhere.
You just can't see anything. I mean,
it's like the haunted woods.
We just missed Halloween.
I'm feeling some Halloween vibes right now. Chupacabra jump out in the trees.
Or the leprechaun.
Yeah, I don't want to say. If I see a leprechaun, I'm jumping in the water. See how light it is up in there? And it's dark.
It's
back
dark
in here.
Down here.
It's cool, though. I will say that. Oh, I remember this spot.
Okay, we got to go left.
Yeah, remember this is a...
Yeah, barely.
This is where we hit the log?
Yeah, I don't know. What is, I'm going to set this joker down.
Yeah. Am I cutting right? What am I doing?
I believe so. Don't hit that log.
No.
Go right. Oh, sorry.
Are you sure it was right?
I don't know. I
had to be right.
Yeah, I think so. It wasn't as hard coming in. Cause,
no.
But I think I remember this. You're good. I got the camera rolling, so we're.
Dude, this is nuts, man. But I like it. Can't see. Where are we going?
Go to your right.
All right.
Go to your right. Go to your right.
Is that? I think that's just a little bitty.
Yeah, it's a little one. We all over these trees now.
They're all over us.
Yeah, they're all over us. Wasn't our fault. Now here's the tricky part, because this is
which way are we going?
Straight. Yeah, I think. I don't. Here's the thing, because the water is high, it's hard to tell where you're going.
Yeah,
it's all flooded. All flooded.
All right. Well, which way am I going?
Right. Yeah, I remember this.
You remember that tree underwater?
I think. Hell, I don't know. I don't know.
I've seen about a bajillion of them.
Great idea, huh?
Great idea.
That's what you do when you come afar. It's like you up some roads untraveled. Hey, we're going to catch a fish, though, I promise you.
No, you're going to be eating pork brains.
Oh, no, we're going to catch a fish, I promise you. I ain't never been skunked.
Our GPS turned off right here.
Okay, well. But you didn't have the GPS on at this point.
I thought I did.
I don't think you did.
Okay. You have something you can anchor us with?
No, but I don't think we're going to move much.
I think we'll be good, honestly.
Yeah, I do too. So we're in Mill Lake right now. We decided to kind of sit here and bait a hook and see if we can catch a catfish. Or whatever bite. We figured the further we go, the more we're pushing our luck. Because we had some close calls coming through coming through the jungle there.
Coming through Far Bay.
Far Bay. I mean, I already cleared a bunch of the sticks out, but with a bunch of sticks and limbs in here with us. It's a challenge.
We got enough firewood just in a boat. Going from the saltwater lure, the old North American catfish
food. All right, get us some mood lighting. Lucy light here. Farge going to buy some of these once he sees this.
Okay.
Oh yeah. Boom. Just like that.
What the hell?
It's that? Inflatable, man. It's like a little. And it's got a solar panel on it.
Look at that.
It'll even charge your phone.
Does it run off moonlight?
No, it don't quite run off moonlight. I mean, it gives off a lot of light, though.
Yeah, it does.
That light's way too bright.
If that don't work, I don't know what we're going. We'll pour this out so we don't get in.
Appreciate it. And we'll chum the water a little bit.
It's called chumming.
Mm-mm.
I'm gonna tell you, they don't smell great.
Alright. See what she'll do.
Let's see if that dog will hunt.
Alright, we made it back, but just barely. We were coming up the creek, and Tyler's like, it's just up here on the left. I'm like, no, man, it's on the right.
Yep. Definitely on the right.
It's tricky as all get out up here. Everything looks the same. But we're starting to get a little cold, so we got to get this fire rolling.
Yeah, and the hogs didn't get our food.
Yeah, the hogs did get our food. We got all kinds of stuff to throw on the grill. No catfish, though. That's all right. And what we got in the skillet?
Well, what we're doing here is a little Sue's chicken heart stew. It's called cowbunga stew down here on the
Jock the Hatchie.
Jock the Hatchie slash. And on the chocolate hashy slash, what do we name that little creek? Without a paddle.
Crucible Creek.
The Crucible Creek.
Crucible Creek.
I took my eyeball out earlier, and he about went in the water. We didn't catch a thing.
It's true,
we didn't catch a fish. So look, we're having the Crucible Creek stew, which is soup and chicken hearts, with little dales and little gunpowder.
Yeah, gunpowder.
And then for dessert, we have pig brains.
They're a little flimsy. Well, we got our 10-pound skillet on there.
Little Crucible Creek stew. Boy, it's hot now. You don't like that, you're stupid.
You're stupid. What do they say? Crucible Creek ain't for sissies.
No. Crucible Creek is not for sissies. I don't know what's going to happen here, just to be honest.
That sauce just disintegrated into gravy.
I don't know. It could be great. It could be terrible.
That's plenty for me, man.
There's only one way to find out. Well, you don't want to go to bed on a little empty stomach.
Look at that, man. That's like a pound of meat.
Some of them chicken nuts. I mean, it does smell good.
Hold on, I got two hands. Got it.
Watch it be my baby.
I know. I think it is going to be pretty good. They're pretty warm, but
yeah.
Oh yeah, man. It's good. Yeah, it can. Well, no, it doesn't need any more salt. Heck, it's pretty good. Yeah, I'm for real. Let's try some sauce.
Shipboard far.
Good. Oh, the sauce is best. Absolutely.
You mix a lot of sauce and chicken heart.
The sauce is where it's at.
Good.
Get your son, big day. Shockingly good.
What's wrong with that?
Man.
Tell you what now. All day.
You can't beat it, man. You did a good job. I'm very shocked. I'm very shocked it's as good as it is.
It's really good. I'm not joking. I ain't making this up.
It's pretty good.
I have a strong gag reflex. Now for dessert, pig brains and ranch beans.
Good little punishment meal. Not like everything else we're eating is not considered a punishment meal to some people, but this week on Far Factor, we got the ranch style.
I didn't bring the pig brains.
The pig brains. You can blame me for the pig brains. I'm good.
Don't blame it on the
alcohol.
Blame it on the pig brains, because
that's right.
What's going to make you sick.
Oh, dear.
Okay.
We're going to the pig brains.
I need a fork for this.
If you can't spoon it, fork it.
Can I chase it with chicken heart?
No, you can't chase it with nothing.
Oh my God. That looks terrible.
It does look really rough.
No, yeah, it looks awful.
All right, I'll do the honors.
I don't know if that's done. You think?
Yes, man, it's cooked. Let's do right.
Oh, man. Oh.
Yeah, look at that. That's the prefrontal cortex right there. Whatever they call it.
Sure, we didn't get a can with the fallopian tubes.
No, not. All right, you ready?
Oh, God.
Let's go for it. It's like kind of like Spam. Maybe a little more creamier. Don't spit it out. It ain't that bad. It's not that bad.
It's the texture is weirding me out.
the texture's a little rough.
Yeah, dude.
It's a little creamy.
It's like eating soggy cardboard.
Or like a liver.
Yep, yeah.
It's like soggy cat food.
That's what it's like. Okay, you shouldn't have said that.
Yeah. I mean, the taste is good.
I like the cardboard analogy better.
I don't mind the taste.
Yeah.
The texture is...
yeah. All right.
Have to grow on you. As much as pig brains can grow on you.
Yeah. Next up, ranch style beans.
Yeah.
Oh, somebody didn't open the can all the way.
No, I did it on purpose. That's a pro move.
Oh, is it? Well, that pro move is screwing us now.
Yeah, we'll just...
Oh, God. Let's taste the sauce.
It's still cold, but just...
Oh, you got it open.
Oh, we're good.
Them on fire some
more. I mean they're not bad.
Yeah. Those are great.
They ain't pig brains, you know.
I mean,
don't get me wrong, there's no pig brains.
But... Yeah, the pig brains.
Oh, that's warm.
The fire's hot down there.
Ain't nothing like pig brains on fire.
You taking them out? That's what I'm talking about. That's a trooper right there. All right, drink the juice.
Oh, no.
Oh, good job, Mr. Farr. I'm proud.
Put them close to the grill and start warming them up.
Yeah. What the hell is that?
That tripwire.
This ain't a buffet style breakfast here. I don't know what it is. The old redneck smorgasbord. It's red hots, boudin, and chicken hearts and soup. Served with a Lipitor and a heart stamp.
We'll start it off with some muscle milk though. Tyler started off with some Doritos. Any ranch style beans left?
Oh yeah. Well, honestly, I'm surprised they have no coons or anything come out.
You know, I've had coons one time.
You got a fire and stuff?
Yeah, I was at Cape Sandblast on my kayak, and I was in my hammock, and I heard some rustling during the night, but I didn't get up to check on it. Got up the next morning, and they had pissed all in my kayak.
Oh, God.
For real, man. It was one of the sit-in sides. You know, it wasn't just sit on top. You could just wash it off. You could see where they'd been crawling inside my kayak and pissing in there. They didn't mess with any of my stuff, though. I don't remember. I mean, I have been on an island in the Keys. All right, we got camp broke down. We're ready to ride.
In my nasty boat.
Ready for a
washing
now.
Yeah.
Hello? Hey,
Bubba.
Hey.
How's things going, son?
Hey, it's going good. We're just packed up camp, about to get on the boat and head back down the river.
Your camera gonna be all right there?
Yeah, for right now. Hopefully if we hit anything, it'll come this way.
If it falls, I'll get in and get it. The water's pretty clear.
Anyway, it'd be a good time to see a gator.
Yeah.
I can...
Watch your head. You're all right, but...
Thank you.
Get a shot of that.
I'm a
bubba. That's too cool, man.
Captain Phillips Rescue.
That's cool, man. I'd love to see it. Look, and he's got fans on it. See the little white things on the hatches?
Oh, yeah.
They're solar fans.
So he probably bought this.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
Boathouse.
Yeah. And he's even a Boat US member. That's like free towing. All right, folks, that's the end of another adventure. Thank y'all for tuning in. Appreciate it, Tyler, for joining me, man. Had a heck of a good time. Can't wait to do it again. All right, folks, don't forget to subscribe. Check out all the other adventures. There's a ton of good ones. More good ones coming. Take care of yourselves. God bless, folks. Catch y'all in the next one. Love ya.